So we're going to go over some commonly used herbicides for this these treatments, both stem injection and cut stump. Here you can see this is Arsenal. So Arsenal AC, it's an applicator's concentrate. It's got a 53% active ingredient of imazapyr. This one is actually Cornerstone Plus, but the active ingredient is glyphosate, and it's at a 41% solution. Garlon 3A is here. The active ingredient is triclopyr at a 44% solution on with it. And then you can see the blue marking dye. So the dye can be added, it's optional, but it's a nice addition when you're doing stem injections especially, even cut stumps so that you can see where you've been working. And then you want to have some kind of measuring cup. We're fortunate that NRCS produced some of these in Tennessee, but have a measuring cup handy. And when you're mixing chemicals, you don't want to spill, so you would want to have a funnel. And then of course, anytime I'm using things, containers that held other products, I try to, you know, write herbicide all over the container so it won't be confused. I also carry a Sharpie. Here's one. So I always got a Sharpie with me to write dates and what herbicides have been used within that container or stored. Clean water. Here's a good spray bottle. You don't want to just use any spray bottle, so it's good to get spray bottles from places like forestry suppliers. And generally you want something that would hold at least 24 ounces. Other products as far as safety goes is having at least 14 mil nitrile gloves. As you can see, they're a little thicker than you would get at like a surgery room. And of course, eye protection. And you can see here, I've got the hat, hard hat. And of course, a mask. Anytime I'm using this on a regular basis, I would want to use some kind of mask. This is an RZ mask. It's quite comfortable. I probably won't be using it today, just for the purposes of this video. There are a lot of herbicide products that you could use for this sort of treatment, controlling whatever the species may be, non-native invasive species, or other trees and shrubs. But these are three herbicides that work really well. They're very effective on a variety of species, but always read the label to see, you know, if it would work on your intended target. So this one is Arsenal AC that I mentioned before, and generally if you want to use it for cut stump treatment and stem injections, you would utilize about a 10 or a 20% solution when mixing it up in a spray bottle. The active ingredient is imazapyr, and it is soil active, so you want to be you know, real careful when you're applying this product. And then this is Cornerstone Plus. It's a 41% solution though of glyphosate. So glyphosate is the active ingredient, controls a variety of species. Again, read the label, but most of the time we'll recommend a 50% solution be mixed in a spray bottle. So half glyphosate, you know, the Cornerstone Plus in this case at a 41% solution, and then half water. And this Garlon 3A, the active ingredient is triclopyr, but notice it's 3A, not 4. 3A means it's the amine solution, which is a salt solution or formulation, and it tends to stay put, which is good. So it works really well for this method as far as stem injection and cut stump. And the Garlon 3A, or even an Element 3A, which would be a similar product, just different brand, but the active ingredient triclopyr, we generally recommend a 50% solution mixed in a spray bottle with water. All right, so before you get ready to mix these products, it's always good to have your PPE. Got my eye protection, gloves, long sleeves, long pants. A lot of times if I'm using broadcast application, I'll actually wear rubber boots. I have a hard hat on because I'm getting ready to work in the woods, but you can see when you're getting ready to mix, you know, you want to be as precise as possible. So for example, if I was going to use glyphosate at a 50% solution with my water, then you can see, and many times when we do this, we're working usually with another crew member, or even family member if you're working on private land. So you'll have multiple spray bottles. So I'll usually mix things up in a jug separately and then pour that out into each of those spray bottles individually. But in this case, let's say we wanted to go 64 ounces of herbicide mix. So in the case of glyphosate, I'm going to fill this up to 32 ounces, and then the next 32 ounces is going to be water, and then I would top it off then with my blue marking dye. Keep in mind this blue marking dye, you really don't need much at all. Just a couple drops in a case like this, and it'll be plenty for, you know, this amount. An example here with the imazapyr, which is Arsenal AC in this case. Let's say I wanted to mix it alone in a 20% solution, or as a 20% solution, or let's say a 10% solution. Let's do kind of easy math. And you know you need 64 ounces total for what you're doing at that time. Then in that case, what's 10% of 64? So if you do the math and you move that decimal point, so that'd be 64 times 0.1. And if it's 64 times 0.1, then that's 6.4 ounces. So I would measure out 6.4 ounces in my cup. And of course I would fill it up then with water, let's say up to 32 ounces. And then I would pour in or mix in my Arsenal AC. And then I would finish by topping it off with the water and then my blue mixing dye. So for this kind of work, again, PPE, work your way down from head to toe, hard hat, eye protection. You're gonna have ear protection as well, or should. In addition, you might wanna have that mask. And I generally try to work when there's no wind. So the morning when it's cool is a great time to do this kind of work. And then you wanna have a pair of chaps, good boots that have gripping soles is gonna be important. Another thing to mention as far as tools, the machete. So machetes work really well, and we'll go over that in a minute as far as the use. But machetes work good, I think, on smaller diameter trees, things with softer wood, and shrubs. Whereas, you know, a hatchet works great, but I think hatchets work better on larger diameter trees and woody species that have dense, hard wood. And of course, you're going to have a spray bottle, and you'll notice here, my spray bottle, I'm going to have my gloved hand here where, you know, I'm using the herbicide, versus this hand, for example, I may use my hatchet, but I'm going to have a work glove on in this case because I'm going to be spraying with this hand, but then I need a good, sturdy work glove as I'm using some of these tools. As far as a chainsaw, we usually recommend a smaller saw like this. You can work a lot longer without getting exhausted or tired. That's more likely a time when you're going to get injured is when you're tired. But smaller saws work great, and there are a variety of good brands like Steel and Husqvarna and others. But I really recommend these smaller saws for your girdle and spray and your cut stump on smaller trees.